Sayyidina Abu Bakr and Sayyidina Rasulullah alayhi salam, they have set out. They are now on this journey to Medina Munawwara. Umayyah bin Khalaf, he's now summoned all the bounty hunters. He's got them all together and he said, there's a ransom on the heads of Abu Bakr and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Dead or alive, bring them back to us. So the job of a bounty hunter is that he goes out. If you ever watch Django Unchained, you will see the bounty hunters in there. And the job of a bounty hunter is go out and boom, he needs to bring them dead or alive. This was now spread all across Makkah Mukarramah. People on the way to Medina, word had got out. Dead or alive, we need Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. Allahu Akbar. In these circumstances, this hostile environment, their life is at risk. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said to Sayyidina Abu Bakr, we will go on this mountain. And we will go and stay in this mountain. Allahu Akbar. How the great Abu Bakr radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. It is narrated by Ibn Hisham in his Seerah, one of the most authentic books of Seerah, the earliest classical books on Seerah. Written on the life of Rasulullah alayhi salam, it is said, Ibn Hisham has written that Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq carried the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam on his back up the mountain of Thawr, and then he said, Ya Rasulullah, wait here. I'm going to go inside this cave and see if it's safe for you. When they went inside, they found that there were loads of holes inside the cave, and serpents and snakes and anything could come out. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq began to fill. He ran out of stones to fill this, so he began to tear his jubbah. Tearing this, he began filling. There was one hole left. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, it is safe for you to go in. And how did he block that hole? He put his blessed heel there. And it was in that hole that there was a snake that bit Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. But Sayyidina Abu Bakr didn't flinch. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq was worried now. Why? Umayyah bin Khalaf now. They've traced, because the Arabs, they were experts in footprints. So they had traced that they had gone up this mountain. Look at how Allah saves His Nabi and Rasul. Look at how Allah protects. Allah Almighty ordered that the spider make a web at the front of the cave, entrance of the cave. And there's a bird that's given birth to pigeons, small birds. And a bird's nest is put there. When they went, they came close there. Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq feared now. He became scared. He wasn't scared for himself. Allahu Akbar. He became scared. He said, look, Ya Rasulullah, they're about to come in. And Umayyah bin Khalaf said, this cave, this web probably has been here before Muhammad was here. And he mocked the cave. He said, nobody can be inside there. So then Umayyah bin Khalaf went. It is in that time Allah revealed the verse, ثَانِيَثْنَيْنِ إِذْهُمَا فِي الْغَارِ. Second of the two, there were two inside the cave. The number two from the two, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, إِذْهُمَا فِي الْغَارِ. When he was inside the cave, the ghar, إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ. Remember when Rasulullah said to his sahib, remember when I told my Habib to tell his companion, the only companion from the entire companions of Rasulullah to be referred as a companion in the Quran is Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Allah said he is the companion of his Rasul. The only one whose sahabiyat has been acknowledged in the Quran. Allah Almighty didn't say this about any other companion. إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَا تَحْزَنْ. Don't be sad. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا. Allah is with us.